Hi, I'm Satyamoy Chatterjee. I represent a company called Analyttica Datalab. I lead their client solutions and product strategy. So today we spoke about me and my colleague Itis. We spoke about prescriptive analytics, and the goal was to demystify the prescriptive analytics as a stream itself, and then how the field is moving from analytics to AI when it comes to prescription. So, you know, one of the things that we want to emphasize that it's very important to contextualize with the business, because many times your tools, data, people who are applying those tools and data to solve a problem can be figured out. But if there is a lack of a context or handshaking with the business problem, then it becomes difficult when it comes to deploying analytics and AI at scale. So if you look at today what's trending, we have there's a lot of talks which is focused on descriptive or diagnostic and the predictive side, but off late there has been a lot of buzz around the prescriptive part as well, because that is where the rubber hits the road and you start creating value for the business. So that is something that we spoke about, and we did that through one of the examples by using our product platform Analytica Treasure and Precision. So it is one of the trends that is very visible is a low code platform. So now there's not too much of a dependency on the coding or the scripting acumen, if you will, right? Because there's a lot of platforms which are now coming to shape, which are point and click and very very low code. So that is something which is trending, focusing on the application where the business comes first. And the problem that you are trying to solve, sometimes people try to kill a fly with a sledgehammer. Many times it is not required, because when you understand the problem and then try to fit your data to the context and solve the problem. So that is something where the industry is headed, where the real impact are being questioned. So if you look at the recent figures, only 13% of the models or the analytics that is being developed are deployed, which sees the light at the end of the day. So that has to go up, and the only way that is being possible when there's a lot of focus on application as against the programming or the scripting aspect for the ML developers. Yes, a lot of things happened, right? So if you look at Google launched conversational AI, a lot of experiments which are going on. Robotic process automation, which is also catching up, and the companies are adopting it to automate and reduce the manual effort, so that can be repurposed more on a more productive way. The algorithmic intervention on pretty much everything, where many things are still in the lab, but many things are getting actually realized and creating impact for businesses. So that is one of our favorite areas, and that is where a lot of focus as a business that we are focusing currently on. There is a need of a holistic thinking. So there is a need of a localized, balanced ecosystem, which can be enabled by technology, and that is one of our platform focus areas, where the technology should enable connectivity all the time. There has to be a collaborative problem solving. Many times what happens that the stakeholders are not on the same page, so it doesn't get deployed, and then the scale comes, right? So there's a need of a technology-enabled ecosystem where not only the development, but a real-time deployment also becomes easy and seamless, so that it can be scaled. So I don't see a gender bias per se or a behavioral aspect coming in. You know, one of the things that is a mindset that it is an area for nerds, or you got to be technically really sound. You have to be a heavy coder to actually enter into this stream, which needs to be demystified. It's actually not. You got to scale your common sense up. Many times you need to develop your business acumen to understand the problems right, and then apply. So one thing that needs to be demystified, that we are not dependent on powerhouse programmers or coders anymore. I think one word would be shifting from Okay, actually multiple words. It will be shifting from awareness to experience. So I'm really, it's heartening to see a lot of participation. The events are getting bigger and better. And people are now actually experiencing it as against being aware and being digitally savvy. Now people are coming together and talking and having conversation, which is very, very good to watch.